guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video, we are going to discuss about one important chapter of mathematics standard 10, that is polynomial. We will see what are the basic fundamental things related to polynomial we will discuss in this particular video. So let us start with the polynomial. Let's try to understand what is polynomial. First of all, we'll discuss with the general form of polynomial. What is the general form of polynomial? I should write it the general form like this, that is a into x raised to n plus b into x raised to n minus 1 plus c into x raised to n minus 2, similar way dot 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 dot. Let me say the number of terms in between them must be anything, plus let me bring it up to that I can say, if I will take it, that is p into x raised to 2 plus q into x raised to 1, that I will not write it anything, that it's raised to 1, plus r into x raised to 0. X raised to 0 means what? It turns to 1. So this is r. This is what we say. It is, this one is a general form of the polynomial. What is the meaning of general form? Let's try to understand. Here in this general form, we can see a, b, c, p, q, r. All these are the coefficient. And here you can see the power of x is n. Then you can see in the consecutive term, the power of n is decreasing by 1. That is n. Then afterwards, it is n minus 1. Then in the next term, it will be n minus 2. Plus up to what we have to bring it, well, decreases 1 by 1. Minus 2, minus 3, minus 4 in that way. That is n would be any number. And ultimately, that is x raised to 2, q into x raised to 1 and x raised to 0. Means what we did here, that we are decreasing the power of x in the consecutive terms. So I should take value of n would be anything. Let me take one of the example. If I will take it, n is equal to 10. Just imagine n is equal to 10. Then what would be the first term? That is a into x raised to 10. The next term will be plus b into x raised to 10 minus 1. So it would be 9. Plus c into x raised to 10 minus 2. That would be 8. Then definitely consecutive term will be here it is 8. Then next will be d into x raised to 7. Then plus x raised to 6, x raised to 5, x raised to 4, x raised to 3, ultimately x raised to 2, x raised to 1 and x raised to 0. X raised to 0, if I will say, then you know that anything power 0 is equal to 1. So this would be the constant term at the end. Now we will discuss about the types of polynomial. Then first type of polynomial is, that is linear polynomial. Linear means what? Then it is having the power of, or we can say the degree of x will be 1. If I will say, I will write it a into x raised to 1 plus, if I will take it first term as a 1, n is equal to 1, then what I should write it? N is equal to 1, then the consecutive term will be 1, that is 1 minus 1 will be equal to 0. So next term would be b into x raised to 0 is equal to 1. Here you can see the degree of x is only 1. Hence, this is called as a linear polynomial. The question must be rise in your mind that why it is considered as the linear polynomial. Then the answer is that if we will draw the graph of this particular polynomial, then you will always get a straight line. And hence, it is considered as the linear polynomial. Here, you must write it, the condition that a and b belongs to R, means they are from the set of real number, or either I can say that they are, this a is a coefficient of x and b is a coefficient of x raised to 0, means it is a constant term. Along with that, you must write it the condition that, or I can say a is not equal to 0. I can write it a is not equal to 0. Why is it so? If a is equal to 0, then what will happen? 0 into x will equal to 0, then the only constant term will remain. So it will not remain as the polynomial. So this is ax plus b is a linear polynomial. Another type is quadratic polynomial. What is quadratic polynomial? Here power of the x we have taken as the 1. I will take it here the quadratic polynomial, the power or the degree of the polynomial will be 2. So I can say a into x raised to 2 as per the general form, as I told that n is equal to 2. Then in the next term b into x raised to 2 minus 1 will be equal to 1. So I should write it b into x raised to 1. 1 means I will not write it anything, that is b into x plus c into x raised to 0. X raised to 0 means it is equal to 1. So ax square plus bx plus c is a quadratic polynomial, where again I have to write the condition that a, b, c, all these are belongs to R, as well as the condition is that a is not equal to 0. If just imagine a is equal to 0, then 0 into x square, this term will be eliminated, then this particular polynomial will convert into the linear polynomial as the x power 2 term is eliminated. Hence, the condition is that a is not equal to 0. Even if b and c would be 0, it does not make any difference. Even if I can write it the example that 3x square is also considered as the quadratic polynomial. And if you want to write it in a standard form, as this is the standard form for the quadratic polynomial, that is ax square plus bx plus c, ABC belongs to R and A is not equal to 0. If I would write to it into the standard form, I would like to convert into the standard form, then I should write it 3x square plus 0 into x plus 0. You can see that B is equal to 0 and C is also equal to 0 because they are also belongs to R, and as per the condition A is not equal to 0. So this is quadratic polynomial. Next one is cubic polynomial. Cubic means what? Cube. Cube means power 3. If I will begin the polynomial with x power 3, then the next term as per the general form, we can say the next term will be, the power will be 1 less than that of the 3, then it means it is 2. So b x raised to n minus 1 means 3 minus 1 is equal to 2. Then the next term will be c into x raised to 3 minus 2 is equal to 1 plus d into x raised to 3 minus 3 is equal to 0. So this is cubic polynomial. Again, I should write the condition a, b, c, d all belongs to R, and the condition is that a is not equal to 0. Here in all this polynomial, either it is linear, quadratic or cubic, here a, b, c, all these terms, they are the coefficient, that is this one a is a coefficient of x square, b is a coefficient of x, and c is a constant term. Here a is a coefficient of x cube, b is a coefficient of x square, c is a coefficient of x, and d is a constant term. So they are known as a coefficient. Here the highest power among all, that is the highest power of the polynomial, will consider as the degree of the polynomial. Then this is 3, so here it is cubic polynomial. If it is 2, the degree is 2, it is called quadratic polynomial. Here highest degree is 1, hence it is linear polynomial. I told you why it is linear, its graph will be always a straight line. Then this is what we are learning about the different types of polynomial. What is polynomial? Poly means many and nomial means term. It is having many terms, hence we are calling it as the polynomial. Here if it is more than 3, then it is 4, or either the degree would be 5, degree 6, then we can call it as the polynomial. So this is what the basic things are there for polynomial. So I hope you are clear with this basic terms of the polynomial.